Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Angular Kanban component. In general, a Kanban board visually organizes and prioritizes the tasks with a transparent workflow. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Kanban component to it. Then, I will explain how to bind a data source to the Kanban, enable swimlane in it, set a custom height and width, add tooltips, and validate specific columns. Let me show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool. In this demo, I will edit my code using Visual Studio Code, and I will view the output in one of the supported browsers. First, I need to install the Angular CLI on my machine using this command, npm install -g at angular/cli. Since I have already installed Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step. Now, let's proceed to create a new Angular project by typing the command ng new project name. I am going to create a project without the routing option, so let me set no here. And choose the CSS option to add a CSS style sheet. The project creation has started, and this will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Once the project is created, I navigate to the newly created project folder. To start using the Syncfusion Angular Kanban component, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular Kanban package by using this command, npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-kanban --save. This will install the package along with its dependencies. Alright, the Syncfusion Angular Kanban package is installed, and now, my application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is, I need to register the Syncfusion Angular trial license key. Open this main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Now, register the Angular trial license key using the register license method. From the 2022 Volume 1 release onwards, it is required to register the Syncfusion Angular license key. To see where to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Okay, let's start to add the Kanban component. Next, I navigate to the app module file and import the Kanban module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Kanban package. Then, I register it within the imports array of the ng module section. After that, I make changes in the app component HTML file by replacing its default content with the Angular Kanban code. Here, I am going to define 5 different workflow status columns: to do, in progress, review, testing, and closed. So, I define the 5 column tags inside the columns definition, which accepts n number of column definitions. To display header text on the board, I define the header text property with the appropriate value. Also, it is necessary to add a key field, so within each column, define the key field property and set appropriate values to them. Within the style CSS file, import the material theme. I added dependency CSS references like buttons, lists, pop-ups, navigations, and inputs. Once the changes are done, save this application and run it using the command ngserve. See here, the Kanban component renders with the 5 workflow statuses. Next, I will show you how to populate cards for the Kanban board. First, I create an object named local data. And assign an array of objects with 8 fields: ID, title, status, summary, type, priority, estimate, and assignee. After that, I assign this object to the DataSource property. At last, I will add a key field for this Kanban component and set it values to status. Here, the Kanban board will render the cards based on the workflow status defined in the data source. Looking at this Kanban board, you can see the cards are empty. If I want to show details in the cards, then I need to assign required data fields to the card. To do that, inside the app component TS file, I define a variable called card settings of type card settings model with the properties header field and content field. For these properties, I assign ID and summary fields from the data source. Also, to access the card settings model interface, I import this interface from the Syncfusion Angular Kanban package. At last, I assign this variable to the card settings property. You can see the cards in the Kanban board are now displayed with task IDs and task summaries. The Kanban board height and width property values are set by default. However, you can set custom values in pixels or percentages. To set custom height and width, define the height and width properties with the values 500 and 1000 respectively. Here, I used pixel values. Now, the Kanban board renders with the custom height and width I set. Check here, the tasks are categorized based on the task status. Suppose you want to display the tasks based on assignee, then simply enable the swimlane feature. Inside the app component TS file, I add a variable called swimlane settings of type swimlane settings model with the property key field. And assign the data field assignee to this property. Also, to access the swimlane settings model interface, I import this interface from the Syncfusion Angular Kanban package. Last, I assign this variable to the swimlane settings property. You can see in the Kanban board that the tasks are categorized based on the assignee field. Next, let's enable tooltips for the cards by defining enable tooltip property and setting its value to true. Now a tooltip is shown for every card in the task board. Let's take it a step further and customize the tooltips using the tooltip template property. I plan to design a table and display the data fields inside it, so I create a template using the ng template tag and assign it to a template reference variable, tooltip template. Next, I add a HTML division element and a table with table row and table data elements. As I said before, I am going to display these data fields in the tooltip, so let me set the labels as assignee, type, estimate, and summary. In order to display the data fields, I will retrieve the necessary information from the Kanban data source and create a data variable using the let attribute. This variable will then be injected into the template for display. Finally, I assign the data fields to the table data elements using the data variable. Look here, the customized tooltip is shown for every card. Next, I will show you how to validate the columns in the task board. I am going to validate the testing and review columns, so I define the min count property as 3 and max count property as 5, which means the testing column should contain a minimum of 3 cards, and the review column must have maximum of 5 cards only. As I plan to display a board with 100% dimensions, I change the values of the height and width properties to 100%. Checking now, the review column card count exceeds the maximum count value, so a pink background is applied to indicate that the validation fails. In the testing, column card count falls short of the minimum count value, so the yellow background color shows that validation fails. Next, I will show you how to bind a remote data source to the component using Syncfusion's Data Manager library. This data manager acts as a gateway between the Kanban component and the data source and uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. As a first step, I initialize the data manager. And add the properties URL, adapter, and cross-domain. In the URL, I will be using the available remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through a post action and bind the resultant data to the Kanban. I have also set the OData adapter here, as the URL is assigned to an existing OData service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. To access the Data Manager library and OData adapter, it is necessary to import them from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package. Next, I assign the remote data object to the data source property. And make sure the remote data source status value and Kanban component column key field values are same. In this example, you can see the Kanban component displays the remote data source tasks in the cards. In this video, we have seen how to add the Syncfusion Angular Kanban component to an Angular application, and how to bind local and remote data sources to it, add and customize tooltips, set a custom height and width for the board, and change the default layout. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Angular suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.